I want to share with you guys another leadership principle, and not just the regular leadership principle, but I like to call the principle, the lying principle. And share with you one specific fact about the lying and how we can apply it into our personal life, into our spiritual growth and development, or to us as kingdom leaders, because it's a leadership principle that will challenge you. So here's this fact about the lying. Lions can easily attack a prey that are bigger and stronger than they are. Usually, you know, I've seen videos of this. There's one moment they attacked a full-grown elephant, a pack of lions. They attacked a full-grown giraffe, a water buffalo. You know, they're very big and monstrous with their horns and obviously their strong hoofs. And the thing is, because the lion understands that, hey, I'm the kid in the jungle, you know, I'm hungry, it doesn't matter how big this prey is, I'm gonna go after it. So what is the leadership principle takeaway from here? What is the kingdom principle that we can learn from this particular fact concerning lions that are attacking the prey that's much larger and stronger than they are? And here's this principle. As a leader or as a child of God or as a kingdom ambassador, we shouldn't be afraid or be intimidated by new challenges and obstacles that come in our way, but only to encourage for us to move forward. So it doesn't matter what new project you have coming up or the things that you've been praying about or the things you've been inquiring of the Lord about, and now the opportunity comes, you're like, oh my goodness, I'm not sure if I'm qualified enough, I'm not sure if I'll have enough resources, I'm not sure if I'll have enough people to help me to fulfill this task, this assignment, or to go on this mission field, where I'm going to raise this money. Whatever it may be, we are continually, as God's children, are facing different obstacles, and these obstacles are always bigger than we are. And the moment you're able to conquer a specific project, an obstacle with your eyes blinded and your hands tied behind your back, well, that's really not an obstacle. It's something that you've already done and practiced before, that's already part of your routine. And my challenge for you, if you're not being challenged with other things, is inquire of the Lord. Lord, you know, challenge me with bigger things, with greater things in life, that I can achieve bigger and greater things. Because you've probably heard this type of a saying before, and I believe in it too, that our God-given vision that He has given for you and I, it's always bigger than us. When you begin to discover it, when you begin to learn about that kingdom assignment that God has placed within your heart and your spirit, man, you're going to be like, whoa, man, how do I do this, Lord? I don't know where to begin. You know, obviously fear will come, intimidation, but as much as with the lions, they understand, hey, look, I understand this prey is bigger than me. There are times the lion will try to attack it by itself. Sometimes there's two lions, there's three, there's sometimes a whole pack of them. So it doesn't matter how it may be. You know, the lion is not intimidated that this, you know, water buffalo is bigger, stronger than it. It's like, look, I'm hungry and I'm going to go after this prey. So as long as we, my friends, stay spiritually hungry to serve our Heavenly Father and to fulfill His purpose upon this life, our Heavenly Father, He has given us specific tools and resources, and our Heavenly Father will send specific people and individuals or connections and or networks or money, whatever it may be, into our personal life in order for us to accomplish that big project, that big task, that big assignment, or those things that we want to pursue, our dreams, our goals, however it may be. And by doing so, you'll be surprised that when you have the right heart, when you have the right passion, when you have that inner hunger, not only for God and for His Word, but also in your hunger to achieve that God and the Holy Spirit has placed in your heart and spirit, man, you'll be surprised of the results. So hopefully you took a powerful takeaway lesson. You know, I'd love to hear your comments below, not only about this lesson, but also, you know, other things that maybe you've personally learned from a lion and how we can apply into our spiritual growth and development. All right, my friend, until next time.